So our question for this week is this: what should we do about all the political division? Now that is a loaded question, but definitely one we want to talk about and discuss. Unfortunately, it seems there may always be some division in politics just based on the vastly differing views. The left is so far away from the right. I think what is so alarming, though, is at the fast pace that this division is growing. And really all the hostility that's coming from it. You see so much anger and so much hatred that this division is fueling. So what are you and I to do about it as believers? Well, number one is absolutely we need to vote. You say, yeah, of course, I know. I can remember being a younger man and not really just testimony. I didn't care anything about politics. I didn't think I could do anything about it. I didn't know if I could believe anything coming from it. I didn't know half the candidates, so how can I even vote for them? So when I became a voter in age, I didn't really exercise my full given right as a citizen to vote, but I wasn't doing my part. And I learned real quick that we as believers have a gift from God, but also a gift here in America to vote, and we should vote every time that we can, every time that there's an opportunity, and we should vote biblical values. That's what you and I can do for this division. And then secondly, I would say this, do something about this division by getting involved in politics yourself. You say, absolutely not. There's no way I'm going to get involved in politics. But there may be some of you that are listening, whether you're going to college or you're considering making an impact in this world. And what greater way than being a part of politics as a believer with a biblical worldview, with truth in your hand. So you're working from the inside out to help work at this division, whether it's the local level, the national level. I can think of a young man who was getting very frustrated with the school system in his local county. And so rather than griping and complaining about it, he did something about it. He ran to be a part of the school board, and he was elected, and he became there on the school board. So he did his part. That way he could cast his voice, and he could make a difference there. I'd say thirdly, stand on truth, absolutely, on issues that truly matter, but do so like this, with love and compassion. You see, Jesus faced a brutal Roman Empire. And as he faced that Roman Empire, he stood on truth, but he treated people with respect. He treated them as he was approached with opposing views and laws and so forth with love and compassion. And that goes so far with us, with our testimony. I say fourthly this, don't ridicule or make fun of those you do not agree with. I can't tell how many times I hear believers tearing down, mocking, ridiculing those in office that they don't agree with. Now, we don't have to agree, and we should not agree with things that are opposed to God's word, to truth, but we should be careful how we treat that person and how we talk about them. You see, doing that ridicule and making the jokes and so forth will never stop the division. And maybe that's not your intention, but it surely works against our testimony as believers in Jesus Christ. How would Jesus treat those people? Would he ridicule? Would he make fun? Or would his emphasis be to reach that person with the gospel? And so lastly, I'd say this, pray for leaders, whether you agree with them or this, whether you do not agree with them. The default is, yes, we'll pray for the leaders that we agree with. But those we do not agree with, we're not going to pray for them. We hope they'll just go away, right? But that's not what Jesus or Scripture tells us to do. Paul writes here in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1, I exhort therefore that first of all, supplications, prayers, intercessions, and giving of thanks be made for all men. And then he emphasizes this, for kings and for all that are in authority. So he reemphasizes the all men here and says, look, I want you to pray for your kings, your presidents, your Congress, your senators, your House of Representatives, all the way down to your local level, and for all that are in authority, for this reason, that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and honesty. So you want to do something about the division? He tells us here, prayer can change division. That is not the least we can do. That is all that you and I can do. He says in verse 3, for this is good and acceptable in the sight of God our Savior. So it's pleasing to God when we pray for those in authority. But verse 4 is the emphasis here, who will have all men to be saved and come into the knowledge of the truth. That is God's goal. And so all the politicians that you do not agree with, that maybe you have hatred for, we need to pray for them. We need to pray for their salvation. I mean, imagine a Senate, a House of Representatives full of believers. Think about a president whose heart is turned towards God. And you say, well, can all that ever happen? Well, he tells us here we can pray and God can work. But we need to pray for them and we need to pray for their salvation.